Hey guys, welcome to another Gauging Gadgets tutorial video. In this video, I'm going to show you how to record your screen using OBS. OBS is free open source software, and it works on Linux, Mac, and Windows. And in my opinion, it's probably one of the best applications that you can use for recording your screen because it is very configurable, and it also exports MP4 video file formats, which is compatible with most video editing softwares. So let's go ahead and get started. The first thing you need to do is go to obsproject.com and check the description for any links that I talk about. I'll have all the links and also a write-up of how to do this down there. So the first thing we need to do is download the correct version for our OS. I have a Windows computer, so I'll just click Windows. Once you download it, go ahead and open it up. Now we'll go through the setup here. Select Next. We'll agree to the terms and conditions. I'm going to use the default install location. Under the Choose Components, I recommend including all plugins because these components will allow you to use things such as your webcam, microphones, things like that. So I'll include the RealSense source. Click Install. Once the install is completed, OBS will automatically open, and as you can see, it's right here. So the way OBS works is you have scenes that are made up of a group of sources. So sources can be things such as my webcam, a microphone, or even a browser window, something like that. A source is going to be a source of audio, a source of video. So basically, we configure those to work together, and that creates a scene that then will be recorded. So in my first scene, I'm going to configure where it's going to record this display that I'm actually working on, and then also include my webcam in the bottom right. So to do that, we first need to add a source. So we go down to the plus right here. We're going to go to display capture. And display capture will allow it to record any of the different displays. So if you have multiple monitors, you're going to have to select which monitor you want it to record. So we'll go ahead and press OK, and then we'll go in here. And as you can see, I have two monitors available. I'm going to select the one I'm working on. And I know it has this mirror effect. I'm very sorry about that. But once I've selected the correct monitor, I just select OK. Now I'm going to go back down to the sources, and I'm going to add video capture device. Press OK. So once you're in here, you can select which device you'd like to use. Now I'm on a laptop and I have a USB webcam attached. So I can either select to use the webcam that came with my laptop, or I can use my USB webcam. So I'll go ahead and select the webcam that came on my laptop because I'm already using the other one to record this stream. As you can see, it shows a preview of the video, and then we can move it around on the screen and decide where we want it to be when we're recording. I'm going to make it a little bit smaller. And then I'm going to put it down here on the bottom right. Now you can select to move it anywhere you want to, on the top right, top left, anywhere you want to. I like the bottom right. Once we do that, I recommend going to the mic or auxiliary port and just making sure all these volumes are good for recording. Looks like these are all fine, so that's perfect. Now basically you have a scene set up. We have a scene that encompasses both recording the display and embedding my webcam into that recording. So this right here is pretty much all I would need to record a tutorial. Now to get it to start recording, all you need to do is go down here to start recording. Just hit that and it will actually start recording, and you end the recording by selecting stop recording. So I do have a couple more tips I'd like to get into the settings here, which I think is very important. So we'll click right here and go to the settings. So as you can see in here, we could change the scene. There's things like that. Go to output. And in here, we can select the recording path where it's going to save all those recordings. And then we can also select the recording format. So as you can see, the default is a flash video. And I know at the beginning of the video, I said that I would output to MP4. Well, there's another step to get that. So what we're going to select is MKV. And the reason I do that is because if you have it in an MP4 format, and say this application were to crash while you were recording, you would lose the entire video. If we save it as an MKV, we won't lose the video. We'll get a copy of everything that was up to that point where it crashed. And then we can quickly convert that file to an MP4 using OBS. After we've changed the setting to MKV, we're just going to go to OK. And we'll start a brief recording so I can show you how to convert that quickly to an MP4. A quick test. And now to easily convert that MKV into an MP4, we go to File, Remux Recordings. We're going to browse and find that file. And it's this one right here. And then I'm going to go to Remux. And as you can see right here, we have the original MKV, and then we also have an MP4 version of that. And that's how you quickly and easily record your computer screen for free using OBS. If you have any questions about this, leave a comment below. I'll get back to you as soon as I can. If you'd like to learn how to stream your computer screen to Twitch, YouTube, Mixer, any of the different streaming websites, check the link in the description for a playlist where I'll have all that information. If this video helped you, give it a thumbs up, and please consider subscribing to my channel, Engaging Gadgets, for more gadget reviews and tech tutorials. Thank you so much for watching.